Hey, good morning. My name is Charlie Corso. I live in Madison, Connecticut. I've got an 8-car car collection. I want to thank Art for filming this. This garage is about 2,500 square feet. It was built as a 6-car garage. Right now, if you're a car collector, you like to jam your cars in, so we got 8 of them in here. And I'd like to introduce you to the cars. You're looking at a 1968 Volvo 1800S. It's a car that was on TV a lot, the series The Saint, with Roger Moore. He drove one of these cars. 85 horsepower, two side draft Stromberg, two barrel carburetors. Made in Sweden. Here you're looking at a 1954 Corvette. The second year they made them, the first year was 53. 53, they were all white with red interiors. They're a completely fiberglass car. Second year, 54, they made them in a few colors. They made a pennant blue, which this is. They made about 350 of them. And the car here has a 6-cylinder engine with two barrel side draft carbs. All of the Corvettes in 1953 and 54 were large 6-cylinder Chevrolet's truck engine. They didn't make a V8 engine in the Corvette until 1956. These cars in 53 and 54 were all power glide, automatic transmissions, no standard shifts they made in the first 2-year Corvettes. They didn't make the standard shift until they made the V8 in 1956. And this is a fine example of this model car.
But why do I continue to write? Why don't you come here? Perché non vieni qui?
Family model. This is a 1967 Volvo 122S, made in Sweden also. These cars were very popular. They are brutes. We call them a brute because they just keep running and running and running. They have the V18 engine that Volvo made. It's probably the only engine, not this car, but that is recorded with 4 million miles on one engine. Teacher in Long Island put more than 4 million miles on one of these engines in a model 1800. 4 million miles. And this is a great car, nice and solid. I mean, you just hear the door. I mean, they're great. And they run and they run and run. I've had this car about 10 years now. All right, here you're looking at the oldest car in the collection. It's a 1936 Studebaker. This model is called the Dictator. It's a pre-war car. I say pre-war, pre-Second World War car. After the Second World War, obviously, Studebaker dropped the name Dictator. They didn't make a Dictator after that. She's been completely restored. She has 85 horsepower. Straight 6 engine. Let's see. It was primarily used as a salesman's car. The purchase price of this car was under $3,000 in those days. In fact, probably under $2,000. It competed against Chevy, Ford, and Plymouth for salesmen's. This car has a complete empty trunk, which is very large. A salesman would carry his wear in it, like his vacuum cleaners. They would sell house to house, or they would sell pots and pans, anything like that a salesman had. Everything in this car, it's a three-seat car, but everything's in the back seat. The spare tire's in the back seat. Even the salesman had his shelves back here for his paperwork. Great example of a early model pre-war car. Okay, what we're looking at here is a 1974 Land Rover Series 3. It is a all aluminum body car. It is completely restored, but has all its original glass and all its original body. It has new upholstery in it. This car was restored and came out of Costa Rica. And that probably allows for, or at least explains why there is no water damage to this car, no rust, no salt damage, nice dry climate. And came into California, and that's where I saw this car and purchased it. Okay, here we're looking at a 1973 Mercedes 450 SL. It's a tri-black car. I say tri-black because it's three-color black. It's got a black top, black interior, and a black exterior, which is not that common. It runs beautifully. It has not been restored. It's an original car. It has about 87,000 miles on it. And this is a car that can be used every day. Every day. Great running car. Okay, now we're looking at the muscle cars of the early 50s. This is a 1957 Chrysler 300. It is a 300C, so it's referred to as a letter car. The first Chrysler 300 was made in 1955, which a little out of character on the letters was called a C300, but then the 56 was called the 300B. And then the 57, like you see here, is called the 300C, and they go on until they went to the 300H. Every year they had to add a letter. These cars were high horsepower cars. They were usually, they were referred to in those days as the banker's sports car. They were big, 22 feet long, six passenger cars. They were all torque flight transmission, push button automatics. They had 378 horsepower in it with 2 4 barrel carburetors, full Hemi engines. A fine example of an early muscle car. You didn't see the muscle cars really come into the picture until the 60s. These are the 50 muscle cars. Chrysler made quite a few of them. But the 300 model, which these are, this 57 probably Chrysler only made, I don't think it would be 3,000. This car here. I can show you the engine on this car because a lot of people don't know what an original Hemi looks like. Find the latch. There's an original Hemi engine. 2 4 barrel carburetors, large 4-inch heads. That's where they got the name Hemi. Hemi, they're hemispherical heads. And in the early 50s, when you were looking at horsepower, almost 400 horsepower, that was a lot of horsepower in those days. Okay, this is the last car of an 8-car collection. We always save the best for last. This is also a Chrysler 300. It's a Chrysler 300 convertible. It is a 1961, which brings us to a letter car of a G, 300G. This car is unique that its color is cinnamon. Chrysler only made a few in cinnamon because at that time, black, white, and red was very popular in convertibles, and most of the orders that were ordered were in those three colors. Cinnamon, this convertible, probably only 14 or 15 were made in cinnamon, of convertibles, Chrysler 300 convertibles. And standing with the 300 motto, or what would you have, this one here is a four-seat car, and that's all. It's got a complete console. The console starts at the dashboard, runs all the way through the back seat, and it's got four bucket seats in it. The front bucket seats swing out, so to make it easy in and out access. The 56 Chrysler, 57 Chrysler, it's push button, torque flight transmission. The interesting part about this car is its engine. Chrysler was making these muscle cars, also in convertibles, and this is a very unique engine. That is a cross ram injection. It's one of the first injected motors. It's got 32-inch intake manifolds on it. Only a few convertibles were made with air conditioning in those days. You had a convertible, why order an air conditioner? But you know, this package on this car was complete. Whoever ordered this car originally said, I want everything Chrysler makes, and they did. They had electric antennas, 7-button radios, everything that Chrysler made other than its record player is in this car. This car has won senior awards, AACA meets in Hershey, Pennsylvania. It's won best of show in all the local car shows. It's a great restored car. They don't come any better than this. They don't come any better than this car. It's completely restored. Frame off restoration. This car was restored 7 years ago, and it still looks as good as the day it came out of restoration. You've seen Cinnamon, that's what we call her. And I want to thank you for visiting, and thank Art for filming this. And if there's any questions, talk to Art. See you later. Bye-bye.